Okay, so welcome back. This next podcast looks at the events of the 23rd of January 1933, which depending on which way you look at it, on one level it was a mistake. Schleicher definitely blundered on the 23rd of January, and on another level you can actually sort of see really how desperate Schleicher's position was by the 23rd of January 1933. Okay, so notice the date. This was actually the day after the third meeting at Dahlem, which we covered in the previous podcast. So Dahlem, remember, is the house of Joachim von Ribbentrop, a key Nazi who played host to a series of conspiratorial meetings that brought Oscar von Hindenburg and Otto Meissner into the intrigues, which ultimately is all about finding a way of persuading the elderly President von Hindenburg that there is no option but to sack Schleicher and appoint Hitler as the new Chancellor of Germany. Okay, so as we said in the previous podcast, on the evening of the 22nd of January, the day before, there had been a secret meeting, or at least it had attempted to be secret. After the visit to the opera, a secret taxi ride in the snow, etc., etc. Schleicher, of course, had as Chancellor of Germany, had his contacts, and he was fully briefed the next morning that there had been some form of secret meeting where Hitler had met with the president's son. So on the 23rd of January, Schleicher was basically not a happy man. So just skipping, there's the usual mind map. Okay, so just always keep focusing on that. Okay, so he got wind of the conspiracy against him, and basically in a panic, stormed into President Hindenburg's office on the morning of the 23rd of January. Basically, with a proposal which was trying to shore up his desperate situation, and basically what he said is he put on the president's desk. He said, "I want your support. You are the president. I cannot pass laws through the Reichstag. So I want you to basically use it in Article 48. I want you to sign off four emergency measures. The first one was to dissolve the Reichstag. Now that was a fairly usual request. Bruning had been doing it for 2.5 years. Von Papen had done it. I mean, so it was not unusual for the president to dissolve the Reichstag and call new elections. But interestingly, Hindenburg said no. Really, that kind of shows you how, in Hindenburg's mind now, President Hindenburg, he too no longer has confidence in his own chancellor. Hindenburg had not refused that request when von Papen had been to him, when Bruning had been to him. Hindenburg had accepted requests to dissolve the Reichstag and call new elections, but he point blank refused. So clearly Schleicher's got no support left. The only thing that's holding him in office is the backing of the president, and the president declined even that request. The other three requests were also declined. To postpone elections for 3 months. Well, obviously there's no election as far as Hindenburg is concerned. He's keeping the Reichstag. To declare a state of emergency, well, Hindenburg refused to declare a state of emergency. And the final one, Schleicher wanted Hindenburg to prohibit, to ban the Nazi Party and the Communist Party. Now, Hindenburg refused all of those measures. He basically said it's likely to provoke civil war. And interestingly, of course, and Hindenburg reminded Schleicher of this very, very point, von Papen had brought similar proposals to Hindenburg to effectively abolish the Nazi and Communist parties and to declare declare a state of emergency back at the end of November 1932, and Schleicher being the first person then to go to Hindenburg to say, you cannot do that, that will cause civil war, which the army cannot deal with. And Schleicher had used that proposal against von Papen to persuade Hindenburg to dismiss von Papen. And now, of course, Schleicher is walking into the president's office with the same set of proposals that he had opposed when von Papen had used those proposals just 5 or 6 weeks earlier. So effectively, Hindenburg laughed Schleicher out of his office, pointing out to him exactly the same plan that Papen had proposed a few weeks earlier, and which Schleicher had been so opposed. So clearly Schleicher's days are now numbered as Chancellor. He has got no support left. The only thing that's holding him into office was his support for President Hindenburg, and he's now lost that support. The conspirators have undermined his every position. Okay, that's the end of that one. You can move on to the next podcast when we're nearing the end of it. Incidentally, apologies about the sound quality of the previous podcasts. I think the last three, there was a high buzz. I won't re-record those. You can actually still hear it through it. It's just more of an irritant. Hopefully it is fixed with this one. I won't know until I actually finish recording. But hopefully that is fixed. Thank you. Bye.